Hey everybody, this one is called Propaganda for War. So, this is Article 20, Clause 1 of the International Covenant for Civil and Political Rights under the UN. And it says, any propaganda for war shall be prohibited by law. Well, these bought and paid for news media and the Satanist in the White House obviously haven't read this, have they? Dr. Paul Craig Roberts was Assistant Secretary of the Treasury for Economic Policy and Associate Editor of the Wall Street Journal. He was columnist for Business Week, Scripps, Howard's News Service, and Creators Syndicate. He has had many university appointments. His internet columns have attracted a worldwide following. Roberts's latest books are The Failure of Laissez-Faire Capitalism and Economic Dissolution of the West, and How America Was Lost, and The Neoconservative Threat to World Order. So we're going to talk about Dr. Paul Craig Roberts here a little bit. This is his article called Prestitutes at Work. And if we read the underlined portions, if you want to read the whole thing, I would suggest that, pause the video. It was enough to convince me that Nazi propaganda during Hitler's Third Reich was very mild compared to the constant stream of dangerous lies that are pumped out constantly by the American media. Okay, this is all propaganda for war. The U.S. is trying to fight ISIS, which the U.S. created, aids and abets, but the evil Russians and Assad are fighting the innocent democratic rebels who are trying to bring democracy to Syria as a replacement for a brutal dictator who was also elected by a majority vote. The accusers have no evidence for their accusations against Russia beyond the unverified claims of the U.S. government, despite non-existent Iraqi weapons of mass destruction. How convenient! You can't believe a word the American media says. If they say anything correct, it's just an accident. A cynical, mercenary, demagogic press will produce in time a people as base as itself. And that's Joseph Pulitzer. He was responsible for the Pulitzer Prizes. Obviously, there's not too many of those things being awarded these days. The statesman will invent cheap lies, putting the blame upon the nation that is attacked, and every man will be glad of those conscience-soothing policies and will diligently study them and refuse to examine any refutations of them, and thus he will by and by convince himself that the war is just and will thank God for the better sleep he enjoys after this protest of gross self-deception. And that's Mark Twain. In the United States, both the Republican and Democratic parties, with only a few prominent exceptions, have been and are in the pay of the corporate media and communication giants. The press is our chief ideological weapon. Khrushchev. Media manipulation in the U.S. today is more efficient than it was in Nazi Germany because here we have the pretense that we are getting all the information we want. That misconception prevents people from even looking for the truth. Yeah, a bunch of Satanist liars. Do not fear the enemy, for your enemy can only take your life. It is far better that you fear the media, for they will steal your honor. That awful power, the public opinion of a nation, is created in America by a horde of ignorant, self-complacent simpletons who failed at ditching and shoemaking and fetched up in journalism on their way to the poorhouse. Mark Twain. Well said, Mark Twain. The media want to maintain their intimate relation to state power. They want to get leaks. They want to get invited to the press conferences. They want to rub shoulders with the Secretary of State. All that kind of business. To do that, you've got to play the game. And playing the game means telling their lies, serving as their disinformation apparatus. There are laws to protect the freedom of the press of speech, but none that are worth anything to protect the people from the press. Whoever controls the media controls the mind. The business of the journalist is to destroy the truth, to lie outright, to pervert, to vilify, to fawn at the feet of mammon, and to sell his country and his race for his daily bread. You know it and I know it. And what folly is this, toasting an independent press? We are the tools and vassals of rich men behind the scenes who are the jumping jacks. They pull the strings and we dance. Our talents, our possibilities, our lives are all the property of other men. We are intellectual prostitutes. And that is John Swinton, former chief of staff of the New York Times. This is blacklisted website. The New York Times admits that virtually every major news organization allows the news to be censored by government officials. How convenient! One of the most shocking articles that the New York Times has ever put out, a New York Times reporter has openly admitted that virtually every major news organization allows government bureaucrats and campaign officials to censor their stories. That's notice published July 24th, 2012. They are sent by email from the Obama headquarters in Chicago to reporters who interviewed campaign officials under one major condition. The press office has veto power over what statements can be quoted and attributed by name. Most reporters, desperate to pick the brains of the president's top strategists, grudgingly agree. After the interviews, they review their notes, check their tape recorders, and send in the juiciest sound bites for review. The verdict from the campaign, an operation that prides itself in staying consistently on script, is often no. Barack Obama does not approve this message. The Satanist does not approve this message. The liar in chief does not approve this message. How can you tell he's lying? His lips are moving. What all this means is that both Obama campaign and the Romney campaign essentially have veto power over any quotes from those campaigns that we see in the newspapers. According to the New York Times, virtually every major news organization has agreed to submit their quotes for quote approval. What a scam! Today, six colossal media giants tower over the rest. Much of the information in the chart below comes from mediaowners.com. The chart below reveals only a small fraction of the media outlets that these six behemoths actually own. So we'll start off with Time Warner. They own HBO, Turner Broadcasting, Warner Brothers Entertainment. I mean, it just goes down TNT, America Online. It's like who's who. Walt Disney, ABC Television Network, Disney Publishing, ESPN, Disney Channel, Hollywood Records, Touchstone Pictures. I mean, it's another who's who. Viacom owns Paramount Pictures, Paramount Home Entertainment, Comedy Central, MTV, Nickelodeon, The Movie Channel, VH1, News Corporation. I think we're going to get a little closer here. Yes, we are. I guess they're the biggest one. Dow Jones Company, Fox Television, The New York Post, Fox, all the Fox networks, MySpace, Times of London, 20th Century Fox, DirecTV, Wall Street Journal. I mean, it's just like all sorts of them. And that's the list. CBS owns CBS News, CBS Radio, Infinity Broadcasting. NBC Universal owns CNBC, MSNBC, NBC Television Network, USA Network, Weather Channel, Universal Parks and Studios. Please keep in mind that the list above is not exhaustive. Media Corporation share members of the board of directors with a variety of other large corporations, including banks, investment companies, oil companies, healthcare, pharmaceutical companies, and technology companies. So now we're seeing like everybody that's involved. Think about it, people. Anyone that believes that the mainstream media is independent and that it does not have an agenda is being delusional. Former Washington Post reporter Carl Bernstein of Woodard and Bernstein fame has discovered that hundreds of American journalists have worked directly for the CIA. How convenient. You will notice that none of the major news organizations speak out against the Big Brother police state control grid that is going in all around us. Instead, they insist that all of this added security will keep us safe, even as our liberties and freedoms are being badly eroded. You will notice that none of the major news organizations speak out against the population control agenda. Instead, they insist that more family planning will help in the environment and make the world a more prosperous place for all of us. Yeah, let's kill off a bunch of these useless eaters. You will notice that none of the major news organizations speak out against the banksters, and none of them are warning us about the financial collapse that's rapidly approaching. How convenient! The 10 planks of the Communist Manifesto. Abolition of private property and application of all rents of land to public purposes. That's done. Unless you're a state citizen. For U.S. citizens, it's done. A heavy progressive and graduated income tax. If you're a U.S. citizen, that's done. Abolition of all rights of inheritance. If you're a U.S. citizen, that's done. Confiscation of the property of all immigrants and rebels. Proceeds of crime seizures. If you're a U.S. citizen, they do that every day. Centralization of credit in the hands of the state by means of a national bank with state capital and an exclusive monopoly. Again, that's for the U.S. citizen slaves. Centralization of the means of communication and transportation in the hands of the state. Well, how do you spell Federal Communications Commission? How do you spell Department of Transportation? Extension of factories and instruments of production owned by the state and bringing into cultivation of wastelands and the improvement of the soil generally in accordance with a common plan. How do you spell land use regulations? How do you spell the EPA? Equal liability of all to labor, establishment of industrial armies, especially for agriculture. How do you spell the Becerro program? Combination of agriculture with manufacturing industries, gradual abolition of the distinction between town and country by a more equitable distribution of population over the country. Well, that's in progress. Free education for all children in public schools, abolition of children's factory labor in its present form, combination of education with industrial production. Well, That's obviously already done. Our minds are constantly being invaded by legions of half-truths, prejudices, and false facts. One of the great needs of mankind is to be lifted above the morass of false propaganda. Martin Luther King. All propaganda has to be popular and has to accommodate itself to the comprehension of the least intelligent of those to whom it seeks to reach. Hitler. The people will believe what the media tells them to believe. George Orwell. Hundreds of billions of dollars are spent every year to control the public mind. False flags. 42 admitted false flags. Gee, that sounds like propaganda for war. Our horrific staged event blamed on a political enemy and used as a pretext to start a war or enhance the draconian laws in the name of national security. We're just trying to protect you. I believe you. Really, I do. Millions wouldn't, but I do. All false flag operations need willing accomplices in the news media. Although the FBI now admits that the 2001 anthrax attacks were carried out by one or more U.S. government scientists, a senior FBI official says that the FBI was actually told to blame the anthrax attacks on Al-Qaeda by White House officials. Government officials also confirmed that the White House tried to link the anthrax to Iraq as a justification for regime change in that war. Well, gee, that sounds like weapons of mass destruction, doesn't it? Former Department of Justice lawyer John Yoo suggested in 2005 that the U.S. should go on the offensive against Al-Qaeda, having our intelligence agencies create a false terrorist organization. It could have its own websites, recruitment centers, training camps, and fundraising operations. It could fund, launch fake terrorist attacks, operations, and claim credit for real terrorist strikes, helping to sow confusion within Al-Qaeda's ranks, causing operatives to doubt others' identities and to question the validity of communications. And, why is that a surprise? U.S. intelligence officers are reporting that some of the insurgents in Iraq are using recent model Beretta 92 pistols, but the pistols seem to have had their serial numbers erased. The numbers do not appear to have been physically removed. The pistols seem to have come off a production line without any serial numbers. Analysts suggest the lack of serial numbers indicates that the weapons were intended for intelligence operations or terrorist cells with substantial government backing. Analysts speculate that these guns are probably the Mossad or the CIA. Analysts speculate that agent provocateurs may be using the untraceable weapons, even as U.S. authorities use insurgent attacks against civilians as evidence of the illegitimacy of the resistance. Undercover Israeli soldiers admitted in 2005 to throwing stones at other Israeli soldiers so they could blame it on Palestinians as an excuse to crank down on peaceful protests by the Palestinians. Why is that a surprise? Quebec police admitted that in 2007, thugs carrying rocks to a peaceful protest were actually undercover Quebec police officers. Why is that a surprise? At the G20 protests in London in 2009, a British member of parliament saw a plainclothes police officer attempting to incite the crowd to violence. Gee, why is that a surprise? Egyptian politicians admitted that the government employees looted priceless museum artifacts in 2011 to try to discredit the protesters. Why is that a surprise? A Colombian army colonel has admitted that his unit murdered 57 civilians, then dressed them in uniforms and claimed they were rebels killed in combat. Why is that a surprise? The highly respected writer of The Telegraph, Ambrose Evans Pritchard, says the head of Saudi intelligence, Prince Bandar, recently admitted that the Saudi government controls Chechen terrorists. Why is that a surprise? High-level American sources admitted that the Turkish government, a fellow NATO country, carried out chemical attacks blamed on the Syrian government, and high-ranking Turkish government admitted on tape plans to carry out attacks and blame it on the Syrian government. Why is that a surprise? The former Ukrainian security chief admits that the sniper attacks which started the Ukrainian coup were carried out in order to frame others. Why is that a surprise? Britain's spy agency has admitted that it carries out digital false flag attacks on targets, framing people for writing offensive or unlawful material and blaming it on the target. Why is that a surprise? In addition, two-thirds of the city of Rome burned down in a huge fire on July 64 AD. The Roman emperor blamed the emperor Nero for starting the fire. Some top Roman leaders, including the Roman consul Cassius Dio, as well as historians like Suetonius, agreed that Nero started the fire based largely on the fact that the Roman Senate had just rejected Nero's application to clear 300 acres in Rome so that he could build a palatial complex, and that the fire allowed him to build his complex. Regardless of who actually started the fire, Nero, in the face of public opinion accusing him of arson, falsely blamed the Christians for starting the fire. He then rounded up and brutally tortured and murdered scores of Christians for something they didn't do. Why is that a surprise? If they're putting false, offensive, and unlawful material on the internet to frame people, what about bank account security breaches? What about IRS security breaches? What about other government security breaches? It seems like every day they're blaming North Korea or China or Iran for some government security breach, or Russia nowadays. Next time they'll be forcing you to send your sons and daughters to some foreign country to participate in a mass murder of their foreign counterparts as part of a satanic blood sacrifice to Molech, their Satanist god. Warfare equals commerce. That's under the Unidroit Treaty. Commerce under the Unidroit Treaty equals warfare. All this is thanks to your friendly neighborhood Roman cult Satanists. You're the father of the devil, and the lust of your father you will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he's a liar and the father of it. But the fearful and unbelieving and abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. So these liars are all Satanists, okay, number one. And, you know, if you're fearful or unbelieving about all of this, I mean, I'm giving you all sorts of evidence. I mean, the burden's now on you to do some research and find out for yourself if you don't believe it, because if you continue to not believe it, when the evidence is all over the place, you're not going to do too well on Judgment Day. And if you're afraid to spread the word, you're not going to do too well on Judgment Day. I'm sorry, you know, I hope you do well on Judgment Day, but, you know, the simple fact of the matter is we're all going to face it someday. Political language is designed to make lies sound truthful and murder respectable. Gee, and that's George Orwell. Spin equals politically correct equals fraud equals lies. By which he also went and preached to the spirits in prison. And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall punish the host of the high ones that are on high, and the kings of the earth upon the earth. And they shall be gathered together as prisoners are gathered in the pit, and they shall be shut up in prison, and after many days shall they be visited. Spirit prisons, hell. And these people are all going to hell. The single greatest tool of oppression is ignorance. And Mark Passio even calls it ignorance, okay? The root word of ignorance is ignore. And that's exactly what it is. None are more hopelessly enslaved than those who falsely believe they're free. The two enemies of the people are criminals and government. So let us tie down the second with the chains of the Constitution, so the second will not become the legalized version of the first. Well, hello, people. That's what's happened. When plunder becomes a way of life for a group of men in a society, over the course of time, they create for themselves a legal system that authorizes it and a moral code that justifies it. Make the lie big, make it simple, keep saying it, and eventually they'll believe it. That's Hitler and his bought and paid for news media. Huh. Smells like bullshit. Oh, it's just the mainstream media. The CIA owns everyone of any significance in the major media. And that's former CIA director William Colby. Conspiracy theorist, a person that doesn't watch as much TV as you do. Ain't that the truth? The greatest danger to American freedom is a government that ignores the Constitution. Government is not the solution to our problem. Government is the problem. Any society that would give up a little liberty to gain a little security will deserve neither and lose both. And then we told them that the spying is supposed to keep them safe. If we remain silent when our popularly elected government violates the laws it has sworn to uphold and steals the freedoms we elected it to protect, we will have only ourselves to blame when Big Brother is everywhere. Somehow, I doubt my father's generation fought the Nazis in World War II only to permit a totalitarian government to flourish here. And that's Judge Andrew Napolitano. Good guy, I'll tell you. He's a great guy. Fascism in power is the open terroristic dictatorship of the most reactionary, the most chauvinistic, the most imperialist elements of finance capitalism. Gee, that sounds like the bankster thieves. The bankster thieves are fascists. Boy, you got that right. Fascism is more appropriately called corporatism because it is the merger of state and corporate power. Mussolini defined fascism as a union of state and corporate power. Using that definition, can we claim that North America is anything but fascist? Absolutely right. If the American people ever allow the private banks to control the issue of their currency, first by inflation, then by deflation, the banks and corporations that will grow up around them will deprive the people of all the property until their children wake up homeless on the continent their fathers conquered. How many people you see running around homeless these days? Hello? The end of democracy and the defeat of the American Revolution will occur when government falls into the hands of lending institutions and moneyed in corporations. Whoa, is that ever prophetic. It is the duty of the patriot to protect his government country from its government. There's a guy by the name of Mark Passio, a former Satanist priest, has some natural law videos, talks about the pillars of Satanism. And one of the pillars is moral relativism. There's no absolute right or wrong. Truth is relative. We just make up what's right or wrong. Gee, that sounds like one of these kangaroo court cases. What is right or wrong is what we decide today, and tomorrow it'll be something else. Two-thirds of the people, according to Passio, believe in moral relativism. In other words, two-thirds of Americans are practicing Satanists. He's actually said that as well. I think he's being generous. I think it's more like about 90%. One of the pillars of Satanism is order followers. They're responsible for all the atrocities in history. They just follow orders without thinking about whether it's a lawful order or not. They're willing slaves. That sounds like the prostitutes. They're just following orders. They're willing slaves. They're Satanists. Although there's order followers everywhere. I mean, all of the Gestapo thugs you see running around. All order followers. Not all of them, actually, in all fairness. Some of them want to be peace officers. There's actually YouTube videos about some of them getting fired because they object to the quotas. So let me qualify that, because some of them do want to be peace officers. And so the question is which ones do and which ones don't. Anyways, Mark Passio's YouTube channel is What on Earth is Happening. Highly recommend it. A brilliant guy, has a great video on order followers. Says they're cowards and they operate in gangs, and ain't that the truth? Anyone who's wearing a military uniform is an agent of the Roman cult. The wearing a clerical dress or religious habit on the part of layfolk is liable to the same penalty on the part of the state as the misuse of a military uniform. And that's Article 10 of the Concordat of 1933, which was signed between Hitler and the Roman cult. Almost all so-called governments are bankrupt and owned and operated by the Roman cult. At common law, sheriff would have a star only. At common law, there's no uniform. World War II war crimes tribunals, all of the Nazis claimed they were just following orders. Gee, that sounds like they're Satanists. They either suffered death by hanging or spent the rest of their life in jail. Some of them are still hunted to this day. The Vietnam War, the My Lai Massacre, they were all convicted of murder. Today, order followers are everywhere. And it's because they want to make war on you. That's what it's all about. It's all warfare. Under the international law of warfare, all parties to a cause must appear by nom de guerre, because an alien enemy cannot maintain an action during a war in his own name. A mixed war is one made on one side by public authority and the other by mere private persons. Okay, so they're engaging in warfare on you, okay? This is all commercial warfare. Capitis diminutio, meaning the diminish of status. It's all Roman law. A diminishing or abridgment of personality, loss or curtailment of man's status or aggregate of legal attributes and qualifications. Capitis diminutio maxima, the highest or most comprehensive loss of status. This occurred when a man's condition was changed from one of freed to one of bondage, when he became a slave. The president, if he shall find it compatible with the safety of the United States and with successful prosecution of the war, may, during the time of the war, the president may, through any agency that may designate under such rules and regulations as he may prescribe by means of instructions, licenses, or otherwise, regulate, direct, compel, nullify, void, prevent, or prohibit, or exercising any right, power, or privilege with respect to any property by any person subject to the jurisdiction of the United States and upon the terms directed by the President in such agency or person, and such designated agency or person may perform any and all such incident acts incident to the accomplishment or furtherances of these purposes. And that's the Trading with the Enemy Act. So a U.S. citizen is an enemy. All persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction are citizens of the United States. That's the cestui trust. That's the enemy of the state. This is the National Emergencies Act that's found at 90 Stat 1255, which was approved on September 14, 1976, and is supposed to terminate all the national emergencies then are in effect. An act to terminate certain authorities with respect to national emergencies still in effect. and to provide for orderly implementation and termination of future national emergencies. Section 502, this provision of this act shall not apply to the following provisions of the law, the powers and authorities conferred thereby, and the actions taken thereunder. And the Section 5B, the Act of October 6, 1917, as amended, which is the Trading with the Enemy Act. We can't even begin to count the number of times judges, lawyers, and statesmen have said there isn't any common law anymore. It's been replaced by statutes. They'd be more truthful if they said there isn't any common law anymore. It's been replaced by martial law. In the meantime, civil law was the form of law imposed by the Roman Empire, which was largely, if not wholly, governed by martial law rule. Equity has always been understood to follow the law. To have superior equity is to turn things on their head. If equity is the law, then it follows its own course rather than following the common law, thereby destroying the common law and leaving what's called equity in its place. And that's and this last site actually is Diet versus, they're both Diet versus Turner. And this is the non-ratification of the 14th Amendment Judge Age Ellett. I don't know why it says assistant director there. It's Judge Age Ellett of the Utah Supreme Court. Yet still it was found difficult to set bounds to ecclesiastical ingenuity, for when they were driven out of all their former holds, they devised a new method of conveyance by which lands were granted not to themselves directly, but to nominal fiefs to the use of the religious houses. Thus distinguished between the possession and the use, receiving the actual profits while the season of the land remained in the nominal fiefe, who was held by the courts of equity then under the direction of the clergy to be bound in conscience to account for his cestui use. Gee, that sounds like taxes. For the rents and emoluments of the estate, and it is to these inventions that our petitioners are indebted for the introduction of use and trust, the foundation of modern conveyancing. And that's Tomlin's Law Dictionary, 1835 edition, under the definition of mort main. The point being here, there's a whole bunch of points here. The cestui trust was created by the Roman cult, who was held by the courts of equity, then under the direction of the clergy to be bound. They're still under the direction of the clergy. They're bound in conscience to account for their taxes. Okay, that's what that is. And it is, and then the cestui trust is the foundation of modern conveyancing. In 1835, it still is. If you're too stupid to know that's what's going on, why do you think they spell your name in all block capital letters? Citation, a summons to appear. This is all a Roman cult, particularly in spiritual court. How many times you get a citation? You get these Satanist pigs assault you on the street and issue you a citation for speeding or something like that. You don't think that's a Roman cult court? Of course it is. And these are more citations about a citation. Black's Law Dictionary, 2nd edition. Tomlin's Law Dictionary, 1835 edition. These prostitutes are symptomatic of a corporate takeover that's taking place. All so-called courts are corporate courts and business to make a profit. All government codes, rules, and regulations are actually corporate in nature. The current police state is an example of corporate code enforcers. See their martial laws here. See martial laws here video and the bankrupt corporate governments video. These bought and paid for prostitutes publish lies. How do you know when they're lying? Their lips are moving. These prostitutes are owned and operated by the New World Order crowd like George Soros and the Queen. These prostitutes are Satanists. We all need to find alternative sources of information. The only reason I ever watch the prostitutes is so I know what lies they want everybody to believe. The recent fake news drive is an agenda by these mainstream media to eliminate the alternative media because the truth is coming out. And this, none of it applies to state citizens. Taxpayers are not state citizens. State citizens are the only ones living under free government whose rights are incapable of impairment by legislation or judicial decision. State citizenship is a vested substantial property right, and the state has no power to divest or impair these rights. The state citizen is immune from any and all government attacks and procedure absent contract. Every man is independent of all laws except those prescribed by nature. He's not bound by any institution formed by his fellow men without his consent. It's all by contracts. The rights of individuals are restricted only to the extent that they've been voluntarily surrendered by the citizenship to the agencies of government. The people are sovereign, are not bound by general words and statutes, restrictive of prerogative, right, title, or interest, unless expressly named. Acts of limitation do not bind the king or the people. The people have been ceded all the rights of the king, the former sovereign. None of this applies to the people, but most of the people are asleep at the wheel and think they're one of the slaves. At the revolution, the sovereignty devolved on the people, and they are truly the sovereigns of the country. The citizens of America are equal as fellow citizens and joint tenants in the sovereignty. The people of a state are entitled to all the rights which formerly belonged to the king by his prerogative. It will be admitted that all on all hands, with the exception of the powers granted to the states and the federal government through the constitutions, the people of the several states are unconditionally sovereign within their respective states. A sovereign is exempt from suit not because of any formal conception or obsolete theory, but on the logical and practical ground that there can be no legal right as against the authority that makes the law on which the right depends. And again, that's talking about state citizens. Fraud equals lies equals Satanism equals the Roman cult. Because almost everything is done these days with commercial paper, the Roman cult's courts presume that commercial paper was used. The cestui trust originated with the Roman cult. It's the Roman cult that is stealing everything they can get their hands on. The Roman cult is trying to start World War III to reduce the population. Too many useless eaters. I believe, can't prove it yet, but I will eventually, you watch, that when somebody is killed in a war, the contents of the cestui trust account is set off against the national debt. That's the reason these Satanists are trumpeting this war propaganda, because they want to kill off a bunch of people and get rid of some of this national debt. Everything they do is a fraud. Quit participating in their frauds, lies, and Satanism. You cannot claim fraud if you participate in it. Okay, that's what happens because of your own ignorance or ignorance, according to Mark Passio, which he's 100% right. It's ignorance. Anyways, you cannot claim fraud if you participate. Once a fraud, always a fraud. Things invalid in the beginning cannot be made valid by subsequent act. A thing void in the beginning does not become valid by lapse of time. Time cannot render valid an act void in its origin. Out of fraud, no action arises. Any act by any government official conceal a fraud becomes an act of fraud. It is a fraud to conceal a fraud, and a fraud is inexcusable and unpardonable. Fraud and deceit should excuse no man. Any fraud amounts to injustice. Fraud and justice never dwell together. And what is otherwise good and just, if sought by force or fraud, becomes bad and unjust. These are all maxims of law. These are all maxims of law. Under the Roman cult, everything is warfare. All court cases are warfare. All commercial transactions are warfare. All wars are commercial transactions. As long as the Roman cult is around, there will be no peace. These Satanists know they're in violation of their own UN human rights requirements, but it's so good for business. This video is not intended to scare anyone or make them feel like all is lost, because it absolutely is not. We know to know what the problem is before we can know what a good solution is. And the good solution is get back to law. Get back to God, to law. Never give up. Bottom line is never give up. Okay? Never, ever, ever give up. I know thy works and tribulation. I know the blasphemy of them that say they are Jews or Christians, and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. Judgment day is coming. You're of your father the devil, and the lust of your father you will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there's no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he's a liar and the father of it. These are all Satanists, okay? All lies are Satanism. But the fearful and unbelievable and abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. So they're all going to go to hell. But you know, I'm concerned about the fearful and unbelieving, because if you don't believe it, you know, now the burden, you watch this, you need to go and do some research and confirm all of my sites that I put in here. And if you don't, then you're going to be held accountable. Okay, the fearful and unbelieving are not going to do too well on Judgment Day. I hope you do. I hope you're not. You're one of those that are not held accountable. By which also he went and preached the spirits in prison. It shall come to pass in that day, the Lord shall punish the host of the high ones on high and the kings of the earth, and they shall be gathered together. And that's the spirit prison again. It behooves every man who values liberty of conscience for himself to resist invasions of it in the case of others, or their case may, by change of circumstances, become its own. And what Jefferson's talking about there is karma. What goes around comes around. So again, what goes around comes around. If you love wealth better than liberty, the tranquility of servitude better than the animating contest of freedom, go home from us in peace. We ask not your counsel or arms, crouch down and lick the hands which feed you. May your chains set lightly upon you, and may our posterity forget that you are ever our countrymen. And nobody could say it better than Samuel Adams. When shall it be said in any country of the world, my poor are happy, neither ignorance or distress is to be found among them, my jails are empty of prisoners, my streets of beggars, the A's are not in want, the tax is not oppressive, the rational world is my friend because I am friend of its happiness. When these things can be said, then may that country boast of its constitution and government. We have nothing to boast about here. Our prisons are full, are being filled by Satanist order followers. We have the streets are full of beggars, the taxes are oppressive. You know, this is, we have a bunch of criminals that have seized control of the government. Now, it looks like that might change with the new, election, with the new, president taking office. But it's yet to be seen. We'll see. But if the watchman see the sword come and blow not the trumpet, and the people be not warned of the sword come and take any person among them, he's taken away in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at the watchman's hands. This is my effort to make sure that I'm held blameless on Judgment Day. Either you're part of the problem or you're part of the solution. I hope you're held blameless too. But you are now a watchman. Please circulate this video far and wide and spread the word. Other videos, Banks or Thieves 1, 2, and 3, Churchianity Series, Bankrupt Corporate So-Called Governments, Bar Members 1, 2, and 3, Do It Yourself, How Not to Surrender, Volunteer for the Selective Service. Unless, of course, you want to go over to the killing fields. Martial laws here, do-it-yourself, no income tax, no sales tax, traffic stops, free meal, and the three do-it-yourself kangaroo courts videos. Copies of these documents can be found in my private group at Yahoo called Administering and Public Servants. I have YouTube videos that are videos of private information share that show these and other court citations that are available for donation. And this last paragraph is for all the Satanist order followers, revenue officers operating in their private capacity under the Federal Tax Lien Act of 1966. Donations to support this work are appreciated, but I prefer gold or silver coin. You can put your privileges and benefits up your rectal orifice. But as an extremely less desirable alternative, I can accept IOUs, Federal Reserve notes, PayPal, gift checks, money orders, etc. Send me an email for particulars. If you find this useful, then you need to pay it forward. If you don't know what pay it forward means, then watch the movie. Please send me success stories so I can share them. My blog is sovereignlivingwordpress.com. My website is sovereignlyinternational.fyi. My email address is engineerwin@yahoo. My YouTube profile, Sovereign Living. My Facebook community page, I deleted it due to Facebook censorship. And my private group, Sovereignty International, is being deleted due to Facebook censorship. My Yahoo private group is called Administering Your Public Servants, and my Google private group is called Administering Your Public Servants. I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video, and I hope you get something out of it and spread the word. Okay, we need to put a stop to all of this this propaganda for war, because it's all illegal even in their system. Anyways, thanks for watching, and have a great day.